Hello students, once more I am here to give you one more titration experiment of class 12, and this experiment will be the third experiment of titration. The name of the titration you can see 2 given by number of moles of water of crystallization in a sample of pulse of 19.6 gram of which has been dissolved per liter of the solution. So we have two solutions. One is KNO4 whose strength is given, polarity. And one is Mohr salt whose strength is given 19.6. You have to find a number of moles of water of crystallization in the given sample of Mohr salt. So for your sake of simplicity, you must know the formula of Mohr salt, that is FeSO4 and H4 twice SO4 into NH2O. You have to find this N. You have to find this N, number of moles of water in the Mohr salt. This is Mohr salt. So procedure should be one solution whose molarity is given, that is KNO4. We should keep that solution in the membrane. And one solution is Mohr salt whose strength is given. So we must do the titration between KNO4 and Mohr salt, by which we find molarity of the Mohr salt first, and after knowing the molarity of Mohr salt, we can find molecular formula of Mohr salt, and by which we can find number of moles of water of crystallization. So procedure is very simple. Apparatus and chemicals you can write yourself. Procedure is very simple. In the bullet you must keep KNO4. In the conical flask, you take 10 ml of Mohr salt by using pipette and add 1 test tube or half test tube of 4NH2SO4 to make that acidic condition. After that, you should titrate, and heating is not required. So once more I want to tell you, heating is required in case of organic acid solution. So titrate it until the colorless solution converted into permanent light pink. And then write initial reading, final reading and difference. It should be repeated 5 times, and the reading which will come 3 times will be the concordant reading. That concordant reading will be the volume of KNO4. So concordant reading will be the volume of KNO4. Molarity of KNO4 is given 1/50. This you have to find, and volume of Mohr salt you are taking 10 ml by using pipette. So everything is given, only molarity of Mohr salt is not given. That you have to find by titration. So the next part, you must remember the reaction between KNO4 and Mohr salt is this, where you can see 1 mole of KNO4 react with 5 mole of Mohr salt. That's why here 1/5 depend upon. So next part is our titration part. So we are going towards the titration part. As I told, so take, this is titration flask. Take, this is our Mohr salt solution, and this is KNO4 solution already filled up to zero. That is filled up to zero. If you can see that 0 to 50, that is the butane. So first of all, we take a 10 ml of Mohr salt. by using pipette you should take 10 ml of Mohr salt in a conical flask like that, and that makes acidic by using 1 test tube of CoNH2SO4. That is colorless. Now titrate it. See, the initial reading is 0. Titrate it against KMnO4, and that is the most vital point. So you must see the end point of the reaction, when the color will be light pink, permanent light pink. That will be the end point. So you can say that this is the light pink, sir. Stop it. That is the light pink. It's a came. That is coming. It's came light pink. So this is the first reading when we had initial reading was 0 and the final reading was 5. So the difference is 5. That reading must be repeated, that color. That reading must be repeated 5 times, and we should move towards the calculation. Every reading, initial reading, final reading, you have to read. And that we have, that concordant reading is 5. Molarity 150. So that is not given. So M Mohr will become 1 by 20. After calculation, it will be 1 by 20. So we know that the strength is equal to molarity into molar mass. So by strength is given 19.6, and molarity will be 1 by 20. So molar mass will be 392. Molar mass will be 392, and we know that formula of FeSO4 is, as molar mass is calculated, 392. So molar mass up to here is 284. This part molar mass is 284. So 284 plus N into 18 is equal to 392. So N is equal to, that is answer, N is equal to 6. So result is the number of moles of water of crystallization is 6, and by this way we can find the number of moles of water of crystallization, that calculated 6, and this is very important for your board exam. Every external wants to give this titration. Thank you very much for your attention.